Dear friends, beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Brother Frank greeting you from the International Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. It's my privilege to talk to you about the Lord Jesus Christ, about salvation, about the return of our Lord, also about the fulfillment of Bible prophecies in our time. For us, it is so very important to go back to the scriptures, and therefore we call this ministry Apostolic Prophetic Bible Teaching Ministry, taking the Old and the New Testament together, going from the four Gospels to the book of Acts, continuing with all the epistles written to the churches and individuals, and then winding up in the 22 chapters of Revelation, showing the harmony of God's Word. Beloved, it is so important to know God's Word and to know God personally and to avoid all interpretations and come back to the original teachings of the Holy Scriptures. We are living in a very, very special time. It's actually the end of the end time. And we look around, especially in Europe, seeing the coming up of the old Roman Empire. Then we see the people of Israel gathered in the homeland from over 150 countries. Beloved, the Lord made a few statements in reference to the end time, especially in Matthew 24, in Mark 13, in Luke 21. He also mentions his people, his covenant people, Israel, in the symbol of the fig tree, that when we see the fig tree coming to life again, that would be the time and even the generation that should not pass until all things be fulfilled. Then a very special point for me is this, that everything must be revealed to us by the Holy Spirit. Without revelation, you cannot even walk a single step. You cannot follow Christ. You cannot know Christ. I like to refer to Matthew 11 in regards to this. Matthew 11, verse 27. All things are delivered unto me by my Father, but no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father except the Son, and he whomsoever the Son will reveal him. It's all divine revelation. Even Jesus Christ is God manifested in the flesh. 1 Timothy 3:16. Beloved, we cannot go by head knowledge, not by church knowledge, not by the wisdom of this world, not by the explanations of the church fathers. We must return to the footsteps of the apostles and prophets. We must return to the true foundation, which is Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Upon him the New Testament church is built. He is the chief cornerstone. He is Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. But coming back to this statement, no one knoweth. You don't know. I don't know. Not a single person on earth would know unless divine revelation comes our way. Then in Matthew 16, the very well-known chapter to all of us, it says here, our Lord speaking in verse 18, flesh and blood has not revealed this to you. What was it? It was a divine revelation. Divine revelation. As I said, Jesus Christ is the very personal revelation of God in human form. He is the only one who could say, if you have seen me, you have seen the Father. Some make a comparison between what the Lord had said, that husband and wife are also one. But if you see the husband, you don't see the wife. And if you see the wife, you don't see the husband. But our Lord says, if you have seen me, John chapter 14, you have seen the Father. Beloved, I have to make a few statements in regards to the true teachings about God, about water baptism, about the Lord's Supper. We have gone astray in all these teachings. The Bible is not used, it's misused. People are decorating themselves with scripture to cover up their own teachings, their own ways. And the time has come for each and every one to know that God's word in its original form is what we have to believe. God's word remains forever. To give you an example of what I try to bring out to you is this. If you look into recent times, now we are facing reality here in Europe. The old Roman Empire, as predicted in Daniel chapter 2, and also dealt with in Revelation chapter 13 from verse 1, is coming up, and 500 million will be united in Europe, the old Roman Empire. Beloved, we have to understand, and even if you are at the utmost parts of the earth, let's say in New Zealand, Australia, if you're in Russia or in the African countries, beloved, we have to have a look at the things predicted and prophesied in the Holy Scriptures, which take place now at the end time. Today, we can travel from Germany to Spain to Italy. We can travel to Greece. We can travel everywhere. We don't need a passport anymore. No identity card. We just can travel. And we have the same money, the euro. Beloved, if we look into Bible prophecies, we can say that now scripture is fulfilled. Then if you go to Jerusalem, we also understand God brings his people from all the nations whereunto they were scattered. At the same time, the veil of Moses is still upon them. If you look onto this picture here, just near Eilat at the Red Sea, just before you cross from Israel into Egypt, They were dancing 3 days, dancing around a golden calf. And even the press would criticize them. 420 hotel rooms were especially taken for this big celebration. And that takes place in Israel at the Red Sea, just there, about there where Moses led the children of Israel into the promised land, crossing the Red Sea. What is it? Even Israelites don't understand as yet the plan of salvation. Their time comes when our time is over, according to Acts chapter 15 from verse 13, and also according to Romans chapter 11 from verse 25. The time for Israel comes. Then not only this, but another picture has gone through the news and the newspapers. Someone born as a Jew in Algeria is now the highest Roman Catholic personality, the bishop in Jerusalem. And imagine what takes place. The Roman Catholic Church having its way in the Holy Land. In 1948, the Roman Catholic Church used the ambassadors of Italy, Spain, and also of Ireland, so that they would look after this matter, that Jerusalem should be placed under the auspices of the Roman Catholic Church. Beloved, we see everything moving up to the point where the covenant is going to be made. Rome will make the covenant for 7 years with Israel and the surrounding countries. But we see how the track is set and how everything is moving into this direction. And then we see how the United States try to take care of the terror and the terrorists. But let me tell you today, even if you look into this world-renowned Newsweek, you see the American GIs playing their part, and not only playing, but praying, Lord, just help us to kill them. How can a child of God pray, Lord, just help us to kill them? Thousands upon thousands were killed, but also, as the scripture says, wars and rumors of wars. There is such a chaos on earth as has never been before. At the same time, God's children walking in darkness. We now have 550 million, as the press and the news tells us, Pentecostals, Charismatics, and we as preachers would say they are full gospel people. 550 million. The biggest group on earth are now Pentecostals. And beloved, if you look into this matter, all walk in their own ways, all have their own teachings. If you ask them today, what do you believe about God? They will quickly tell you, we all believe in the Trinity. I have the Catholic Catechism before me with over 700 pages. And here you can read it on page 66. In order to articulate the dogma of the Trinity, I don't need a dogma. If you need one, it's okay with me. I cannot blame you. And God lets everything exist. Even Satan exists. Everything is still in existence, right and wrong. But I, Brother Frank, have a call from God to preach the word of God the way it is written. You may have your own choice, your own ways, your own teachings. You may believe in the Trinity, that God exists from all eternity as three individual persons. And then they tell us that there was a moment when the Son is not yet been, but God the Father has given birth to God the Son. I beg you to take this word of God from Genesis to Revelation. Where does the scripture in one place tell you that God in eternity as Father has given birth to a Son? Nowhere, nowhere, nowhere. The birth of the Son was announced from Genesis 3:15 that the seed of the woman would come and the Son would be born, as also writes to the Old Testament. And then to finalize it, you find it in the prophet Isaiah. A virgin will conceive and bear a son, and then a son is born unto us, not in heaven, but in Bethlehem. Brothers and sisters, you might even say, Brother Frank, you are against all the churches. I'm not against all the churches. I'm against all the false teachings. Even if you go to baptism, they use or misuse Matthew 28:19. As we all know, God has revealed himself for the purpose to redeem us, to bring us back into our original relationship as sons and daughters with himself. God manifested himself as our Father in heaven. Therefore we pray, our Father who art in heaven. We don't pray our Son who art in heaven, or our Holy Ghost who art in heaven. There's not such a prayer in the Holy Scriptures. It's in the churches, but not in the Church of the Living God. Beloved, I have to mention these things. I could go with all the charismatics and fool you and deceive you, but I cannot, I must not. I wish to spend eternity with you, and therefore you must know the truth. I know it's not to make friends to preach the truth, but only the truth will make you free from all legions, from all interpretations, from all the wrong teachings. We must come back to the original teachings and practices of the Word of God as found at the beginning of the New Testament. We cannot go back to councils. We cannot go back to Athanasius, to Hieronymus. We cannot go back to the church fathers. We must go back to the apostles, to Peter, to John, to James, to Paul. We must go back to the book of Acts, because that is when God and where God established the New Testament church on the day of Pentecost. That was the most important day for the New Testament church. On the cross of Calvary, our Lord and Savior paid the price. He shed his blood. He gave his life. He redeemed his church. But on the day of Pentecost, that church was established. And Peter, the apostle, with divine authority, having the keys to the kingdom of God. He unlocked the mystery of Matthew 28:19. And there he mentions the name which is not mentioned in Matthew 28. God is our Father in heaven. He manifested himself in his only begotten Son, our Lord and Savior on earth. And he also manifests his power by the Holy Spirit, God above us, the same God with us, the same God in us, three different manifestations for one great purpose. And beloved, if you would read slowly Matthew 28:19, our Lord says, baptizing them into the name. What is the name which is above every name? What is the name for our salvation? In what name does God redeem? In what name does he heal and save? In what name? What name? All the things we are to do, we have to do them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And every baptism of those who believed in Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, believed in the shed blood on the cross of Calvary, were justified by faith, believing what God had done, because God was in Christ reconciling the world with himself. And therefore, the Apostle Peter preached the first sermon, and to me that is valid for all time, even throughout eternity, because it was God speaking through the apostle. Repent, everyone, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. That is no contradiction to Matthew 28. That is just by revelation that the apostle Peter and all the other apostles, even Philip in Samaria, according to Acts chapter 8, was baptizing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Peter again in Acts chapter 10, and also the apostle Paul in Acts chapter 19, all the apostles were baptizing those who believed in the Lord as their personal Savior into the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Beloved, you might say, is it important? It's not only important, it is a divine must, because God in our time has sent a man by the name of William Branham, and I'm not ashamed to say this. And he told him, as John the Baptist was sent to forerun the first coming of Christ, the message given to you will forerun the second coming of Christ. The message is, ye my people, come out from among them, be ye separate, don't touch any unclean thing, be lined up with the word of God, return to the Lord, and return to Bible beliefs and practice. This is Brother Frank, and I trust it's the Lord speaking to Brother Frank. I don't have my own teachings, my own views. I just have the word of God, which remains forever. I wish you the special blessings of the Lord. And as I always say, I wish to spend eternity with you. Therefore, I have to share the word of God with you. May you understand the time we're living in, and also the promises given for the bride of Christ to be prepared for the return of the bridegroom. God bless you and be with you. We'd like to hear from you. In Jesus' holy name, amen.
Thank you.